Hola mi gente, this is DJ Don Juan. Un saludo para todos los de latinos en Sydney. Los quiero mucho. Chao. See you soon.
Hola latinos en Sydney, yo soy Danny Sands. Aquí estamos en Rico Sundays. Un saludo bien grande a toda la gente que está celebrando su cumpleaños este mes. Y si quieren, bienvenidos aquí en Rico Sundays en Mounties, cada domingo en Mount Pritchard. Nos fuimos.
Pásame la botella.
Un martillo, un baile, cepillo, 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 cepillo.
Hi, my name is Raquel Jaugado and I do personal training and coaching. I'm from Spain and I'm here based in Sydney. I try to help everyday people to feel better, to change their lifestyle, to be fitter, to be happier, to change a little bit the way to think about exercise, about eating healthy, just to feel better, to feel good. Everything is connected with our brain and how we can feel better if we eat healthier and we do exercise. Exercise is something that we should do every day. Every day, and it doesn't mean that you need to train with intensity. It means that you need to keep yourself active, motivated. It's very important to keep yourself moving and not being stable for long periods of time. So you avoid injuries, you feel better, your blood moves from your muscles, and you keep yourself mentally healthier. As soon as we do exercise, we feel the endorphins and we feel good, not only after the exercise, but during the exercise. So what we need to do is trying to remember always that feeling, but repeating, because if we have a good feeling and we repeat something, it's easier to keep going and to keep yourself on track. If you stop doing something that made you feel good and you wait for a long period of time to repeat that, you might forget that feeling. So it's important to keep the memory of something good for your health and something that makes you feel good to repeat and then creating a habit. As soon as you create the habit, everything is easier. Exercise is a very important part of our lives, because basically it makes people feel better. About food, it's important to eat healthy because we usually feel how we eat. And if we eat healthier, everything inside of us works better. Our immune system is stronger. We feel better. Our thoughts are better and clear and healthy. And it's easier to do everything. Everything because we feel better. We are happy with ourselves. Another important thing is spending time outdoors. I coach all of my clients outdoors. I have all of my sessions outdoors. I do groups and I have one-to-one. I coach people for fitness, for running, for swimming, and I can see the benefits of the outdoors. feel like, oh, I don't want to go outdoors today. I don't want to go outside because it's a little bit cold or it's a little bit rainy or something that it can be uncomfortable. But then I think, okay, I'm very lucky. I'm a privileged person because I have to go outdoors to coach my clients because it's what I do. So as soon as I go outside, I feel the benefits. And then I go home and I think how lucky I am that I'm spending most of my time outdoors. Spending time in an open space makes you feel good. And the fact of being outside, seeing the sun, having a little bit of vitamin D, I feel that straight away, every day when I go outside. So it's very important to spend a little bit of time outside. Most of people spend a lot of time working indoors, at home, resting, but even going for a walk, it's something really healthy. And Sydney is beautiful. When I coach people for swimming, everyone is always, always smiling as soon as they leave the water. And I always think how happy people look when they leave the water, but it happens with me too. Every time when I go to the water, it doesn't matter, to the ocean, to a swimming pool, I feel happy. I cannot stop smiling. And I feel good, I feel really good. So I always encourage people to do exercise and swimming and anything, but keeping themselves active, basically moving constantly. Basically, I try to help people to change their lifestyle and people get happier. I can see results and that's why I love what I do because of the feedback that I have from my clients. I have groups, I coach people from Monday to Sunday. You can join any of my group sessions. You can meet a lot of nice people. You can meet me as well. And I can help you to achieve your goals and to feel good and motivated, excited, happy. Thank you for your time. Thank you for listening to me today. And hopefully I meet some new people soon. You can contact me anytime. You can see my contact details. So contact me anytime and I'll help you to have a better lifestyle. Thank you.
Bienvenidos otra vez a otro episodio más de Spanglish Lounge. de Sydney, los latinos en Sydney. Mi nombre es Patricia.
Hola, mi nombre es Cristian Asado.
Hoy día vamos a entrevistar a nuestro amigo acá a latino, Cristian Ravelo.
Hola.
Que es nuestro, bueno, Cristian es actor, poeta, musician en OFA. Okay, so, a ver, Cristian, cuéntanos un poco más de ti, actor, poeta, musician, wow, ¿qué más? ¿Mentor?
Mira, fue algo, no sé, siempre he tocado la música desde chico, tocando piano y todo, y después alguien me dijo unos par de años atrás que sería, who would I be without music, ¿quién sería yo sin la música? Y claro, dije, oye, no sabía a contestar esa pregunta, ¿no? Así que al principio de la pandemia dije, mire, como no se puede tocar la música en los gigs y todo, y pensé, a mí me gustaría empezar a escribir algunos poemas, ¿no? Y de ahí, ahí empecé a ver un poco cómo se puede hacer los libros para los niños chicos también, porque los poemas son de... son para niños chicos, pero también se puede explicar diferentes emociones en los poemas, ¿viste?
O sea que comenzaste con música primero.
Solamente música al principio, pero cuando se escriben los lyrics, las palabras, son poemas iguales.
Sí. Oh, claro.
Así que nunca pensé que tenía esa, esa forma que se puede usar los lyrics como poemas. Vale, ahí empecé más con los poemas y todo, así que...
¿Y solo libros así de niños haces o diferentes...?
No, solamente para los niños.
¿Para los niños?
Imagínate, yo tengo 5.
¡Wow!
5 hijos, así que pensé... Yo creo que cuando crecí como tocando piano, era muy serio. Me gustó el piano, música clásica y todo, ¿no? Pero más o menos... Estaba tan concentrado, como reverente, era very reverent, tocando música piano, tenías que estar serio y todo. Así que fue parte de mi juventud, de mi niñez, que a lo mejor no expresé tanto alegría, ¿no?
Sí.
Y ahora que tengo niños, y ya tienen, el menor tiene 15 ahora, pero pensé, me gustaría hacer estos libros. Una amiga leyó un poema del Kangaroo a su play group y me dijo, oye, ¿por qué no hacer libro para los niños, chicos?
That's brilliant.
¿Hace cuánto tiempo comenzaste con los...
Febrero 2020. Febrero 21.
¿21?
El año pasado, al principio del año pasado, empezó el libro.
Empezó en COVID, basically.
Los primeros libros son dedicados a los animales que fallecieron en los incendios de 2019-2020.
Oh, wow.
Qué lindo.
Y yo viví por un tiempo allá en las Montañas Azules, también crecí en Wollongong, y hay muchas, las playas por allá, Haskesen al sur, también tuvieron los incendios, así que...
Fueron bastante afectados esas áreas.
Conectado a esas áreas, así que ahí empecé, fue la inspiración.
Inspiración.
Yeah.
Wow, that's amazing.
Then also, you know, tell us about you being on the experience of acting. You know, how did you feel about seeing yourself acting? We heard you've been on a movie that was in the cinemas.
Sí. Yo creo que para actuar es como tocar música. Cuando estás en el escenario, estás con la guitarra, estás cantando. Igual se canta las canciones sin mirar las letras.
Sí.
No sé cómo se dice en inglés, en español, pero muscle memory.
Yes.
Igual pasa, se hace. Así que cuando empecé a hacer esta actuación en esta película que se llama Here at West, me salió fácil en ese sentido. Parece que hice la audición como en agosto, 2 años atrás más o menos, y en 4 o 5 semanas ya estaba actuando, ya empecé, ¿viste? Así que yo creo que no tuve tiempo a pensarlo tanto.
Todo natural.
It was very surreal, trust me. Y como soy, me gusta la poesía, el rol fue siendo un poeta chileno.
No, se llama entonces Here at West.
Sí, y son 8 diferentes historias. Set here in Western Sydney. So, así que hay cultura chino, Lebanese, Kurdish, Vietnamese, obviamente un poco de australiano, pero y uno de esas historias son de Chile. In the cinemas, it opened the Sydney Film Festival last year as the opening film night, and then it was nationwide
in
Australia, and then ahora está en ABC ahora. Ahora se puede ver por ABC iView.
ABC iView,
device or whatever.
Yeah, just get the app or you can do it on a computer anyway.
And mira, más que nada, no, esta historia no se ve. You don't see diverse. Actors like this normally.
No.
It's either stereotypes, so there was an article in the Sydney Morning Herald, I think on the weekend, saying it's not like the stereotype of Home and Away or The Neighbours, not very Anglo, it's far from it.
Yeah.
You know, it's representing a diverse,
you'd say more like a realistic approach to
the
Australian communities that we have now.
Reality, yeah. More a reality.
They couldn't go. No fueron a la agencia para que era un actor que habla, Chinese or something. So they had to go to the communities, and that's what happened with my role. Fueron a la comunidad chilena y yo apliqué ahí,
Está muy bien, porque a veces las personas no saben de todo lo que encierra nuestra cultura. Solo dicen los latinos o digamos los suramericanos, como lo llaman todos.
Y más que nada, no fue solamente en español, que no fue tan difícil. Obviamente, yo nací acá, así que mi primer idioma es inglés.
Wow.
Más que nada fue difícil a tratar de hablar en inglés con ese acento latino, porque I speak very Aussie, very Aussie, being born here, I'm very Aussie, but I have to think
I have to
be like my deal, and I think that was the challenging part for me.
Weón, ¿qué te pasó?
Si no es nada.
Uy, ¿cómo quedó el otro?
Bad.
Parece que alguien nos pagó el parque, ¿eh?
Pesado.
¿Felipe no ha llegado?
No.
Guateo.
Felipe, estamos en la cancha. Te necesitamos. ¿A dónde estás? Llámame.
It's like the word, it's like the phonetically you say the word the, but with the accent in the Latino, so the car, it's a very different way of
that's correct,
to think of it that way.
Yeah. So. Y aparte de, digamos, de lo de poeta, de autor, mentor, ¿qué más? ¿Cómo vamos con el fútbol? ¿Algo del fútbol?
Yo soy de cricket, tennis, imagínate. Very, very Aussie en ese sentido. Así
cricket.
Que me encanta el cricket, por ejemplo. Wow. Desde chico jugué cricket, pero igual me encanta apoyar todo el deporte. Cada 4 años trabajo por las Olimpiadas. Por un lado de my creative side, I work in technology. Así que cada 4 años voy al exterior, por ejemplo, está en Japón el año pasado y trabajo con los graphics, todas las cosas que salen con los start lists o the timings, en ese sentido, algo visual.
Okay.
Así que.
¡Wow! ¿Qué no sabes hacer?
Wow. It's the creativity, that's all. More and doing what you love.
That's nice.
You can manifest so many different things in life.
It's good,
really.
Because you're actually doing something with your talent.
Mm.
And tell us about these books. Where can we purchase these books?
So, for people in Australia, they can just go to my website, christianrivelo.com. Or for people overseas, it's Amazon. You just go to Amazon.
Okay.
And you just look my name up, Christian Rivelo, and then they go from there.
Sí, escucharon. CristianRivera.com. Very easy.
That's right.
Okay, so how many books did you have?
Like? There's five. So the first three are part of one series, mm-hmm. and these two are sort of separate, but these are for the slightly older kids, maybe 5 to 8. 9-year-olds. Mm-hmm. These ones have a bit more of a theme or a message behind it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
They're affordable? Affordable?
Yeah, absolutely.
Mm, okay.
Absolutely.
I have a little one, so I might have to, you know, get a few because
yes,
they seem very interesting. The names, I'm glad that I'm me.
And that's a really nice story about a mouse that wishes he was more like the elephant. Mm. And his elephant friend has a dream. He wishes he was more like the mouse.
Mm.
And at the end of the story, the mouse says, "You've just reminded me how glad it is to be me."
It's so beautiful.
Self-belief, self-love.
It would be even for us.
The illustrations are also amazingly beautiful.
Yeah. I was lucky enough to come across an illustrator. The illustrator
so
is from Bulgaria.
Oh wow!
I reached out. I saw some beautiful illustrations, and mm-hmm. I thought, because I think what I think is happening with the last 2 years, particularly with the pandemic, mm-hmm. you know, there's been a lot of disconnection,
mm-hmm.
and I think it's really important that we connect and we start collaborating and start, because together I think we form a much stronger unit. You know,
absolutely.
And was lucky enough and to come across her as an illustrator.
Wow,
it was her first ever book. This one was
wow.
the first.
Wow.
And then I got her to help with the second
this
one.
This one too, you told me that about the Gemma.
Gemma Giraffe. So imagine a giraffe, because this is
giraffe.
Wakes up with a sore neck, it was a young man. Así que tenía la tos.
But that's so interesting, because when did you actually did this book?
I just released it in July, but I wrote the story
before the pandemic.
Yeah, it was I didn't even know.
Wow.
But when the illustrator was doing the stuff, and it's really interesting that there's somehow a link there.
Wow!
And in the end, the mother's love helps
make you feel better.
that's the story.
I know, it's so beautiful. The illustration, like
yeah.
Oh, that's cute. It's got your name.
And the funny thing is, when she was doing the illustrations, her own 5-year-old daughter was sick. She had bronchitis.
Oh, wow.
And so she took a little bit longer, and I said, "That's okay, mm-hmm. you take care of your daughter." But so the illustrations
are amazing.
Have linked a lot to her own emotions as a mother taking care of her own
beautiful.
Daughter while she was doing the illustrations. So.
I want to get all of them.
Absolutely
the
amazing.
Yeah.
And the poems, La Poemas, it helps. It's not just how the kids learn to read, but it also, because I found a lot of parents that don't have English as their first language,
mm-hmm.
the way it's written, it's a very rhythmic, and it's a way that the kids, the parents themselves can read the stories too.
Yeah.
It's very rhythmic, there's a lot of rhyming and, yeah.
I don't usually read books, but I like books with the illustration with pictures in them.
Yeah.
That's the only books that I read. And this one seems very interesting.
Really beautiful books. And the first, each of the first three books mm-hmm. here is, because I've got the 5 kids, I've done 3 of those, and I've got another 2 in that series to
do. Oh, beautiful. So this one is the Here Out West.
Here Out West, yeah.
Out in the cinemas, and we can watch it on
ABC iView, stream it, yeah.
You know, it does some very interesting.
I've actually started watching a few episodes already.
And
it's
we also have
such
the
good
Eight
series.
Nights Out West.
So the Eight Nights Out West, so because the Here Out West is about 8 different stories, cultures,
mm-hmm. yeah.
8 Nights Out West is, it goes to the different suburbs in Western Sydney
mm-hmm.
to explore the food culture of those. So obviously for the Chilean episode, they come to Fairfield.
Yeah,
they go to Paulas, they go to, they have an asado.
Yeah,
beautiful. I've got the guitar, I sing some cueca, like it's all part
of nice.
So yeah, we got the guitar here, so are we going to be lucky to hear some of the tunes? Like,
absolutely.
Come for us?
So this song is called Sweet Butterfly. It was it was a self-reflection.
Yeah.
We're getting sports today, aren't we?
it's a lot of self-reflection. It's in Spanglish,
mm-hmm.
But it is about self-reflection, and that's where we can sometimes, and especially man to man here, Christian, sometimes men can get very in their cocoon state, not wanting to share their feelings, and they just get so busy and they're in their heads.
And you did say you're a mentor.
Men's mentor.
Men's mentor.
That we're all trying to figure out how to say mentor in Spanish.
Mentor.
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 Just trying to encourage, trying to encourage men to speak up and to talk about things. You know, there's obviamente just recently there was a footballer, ex-coach Paul Green, who committed suicide, and a lot of things happen sometimes, not just in, but men don't always speak up, I'm just trying to work in that area to allow men to feel vulnerable enough to speak
beautiful.
Up.
That's beautiful. That is beautiful.
Sort of the sweet butterfly was a period in my time where I always felt like I was in that cocoon state.
Oh, okay.
And the whole idea was the butterfly. We've all got the opportunity to,
that's
symbolic
beautiful.
And it sounds a bit weird.
But it sounds beautiful already.
It's a bossa nova. Ago, I bought that guitar in Madrid.
Wow.
So the first Olympics I did was the Sydney Olympics, but they wrote all the software in Madrid.
Wow.
So when I went over there, I worked there for almost a year, I went, I need to get a guitar. I should have brought my guitar from Australia. And I went, I'm in Spain. I'm going to find a guitar.
It cost me $50.
Yeah. I went into a cash converter place.
Yeah, yeah.
$50.
And wow.
I've had it for 25 years.
There you go.
Wow.
See, I wish I could play.
Yeah.
I wish I could play guitar.
One of those things. So it's like my little. It was my first baby.
Pero como dicen en español, ¿no? Yo puedo tocar la guitarra. Sí, la puedo tocar.
Sí.
Efecto sonido.
Yeah, it sounds different in Spanish. I can't say that in English. That's why I have to say
no. No, it's not translated.
That's the only thing that you can explain as a joke.
Así que, yeah,
nah, sí. So, also, hemos escuchado que eres parte de un dúo. Sí. Okay, con tu partner.
Sí.
Y que se llama Soluna.
Soluna fue un nombre que, como usando la masculina, the masculine of the sol, mm-hmm. y la femenina, the feminine part of the luna, mm-hmm. sort of looking at, because obviously we're partners, mm-hmm. we've been together, actually next month we'll be 10 years together.
Wow, so, congratulations.
And it's been a beautiful experience of, because relationships take effort, right? Mm-hmm. The deeper you fall in love, there's going to be triggers and things, and it's really interesting. Sometimes we've written songs together, because we write a lot of songs.
Yeah.
When we're in those moments of, you know, como estamos en esa emoción, a veces que es un poco difícil, a veces salen las letras, sale la música.
Mm.
So, you know, we write meditation music, we write obviously Latin music, some contemporary stuff, but and my influence de los 15 empecé a tocar música andina, zampoñasquena, wow. Así que a veces esa influencia sale en las canciones, porque sale así nomás, you know?
Yeah.
As much as I'm born here, de la sangre.
It's beautiful, exactly. It's in your blood.
Yeah.
It's in the blood, so yeah. It's been a really nice symbiotic, that's a big word, isn't it? really been an interesting integration of the cultures.
So your parents usually, obviously, they introduced the culture from...
Yeah, I think, well, it's funny because my parents arrived in 1970, so they arrived well 4 years before the dictatorship in Chile, so they came here, mum was a school teacher overseas and she came here and not been able to speak too much, so we spoke a lot of English at home, ironically, and it wasn't until I started playing música andina, con Yapu, con all these bands, well-known Chilean bands, Bolivian Peruvian bands, that I started connecting a little bit more to the music and then the culture. Ahí empecé a hablar un poco más español, you know. My Spanish is far from perfect, but at the same time, I think being able to sing in Spanish and having to understand what the lyrics meant that I had to really think about that, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And that's been the story.
Wow, that's beautiful.
Mm.
And your kids speak Spanish or?
So Nancy's girls do, three girls sort of do, my two kids.
So that's your partner's name?
Nancy, Nancy Matos. And whereas my two kids have lived a lot of their time with their mother, who's Australian, third generation Australian. So
Nancy's also a mentor.
She does a lot of women's mentor. Yeah. She's also a wedding celebrant, but she also does women's circles. I think last week they did a mate circle, yerba mate.
Wow, yes.
With her friend Claudia, they did it in Newtown.
Beautiful.
And so it was like very much.
Where can we find her? Like,
there any... Same thing, Nancy Matos, I think, wedding celebrant.
Okay. So you can tell us, to our todos los latinos que están escuchando, que a donde podemos encontrar a Nancy.
Nancy, so you just go to, look up her website, Nancy Matos Celebrant, wedding celebrant, something like that. I can't remember what it is. but she does the weddings in Spanish or English, and you know what I mean?
So we find you on all social media?
Yeah.
And how do we find you? How do los latinos se pueden encontrar? And social media?
The easiest one on Facebook would be to look up Awakening the Senses. Awakening the Senses is Despierta los Sentidos in Spanish, but Awakening the Senses is a Facebook page. We do events, we do live, we're doing, next month we're doing live music meditation as well, with a little bit of Hindu influence.
Nice.
Because whilst I've been brought up a Catholic, I think there's lots of different religions that we can all learn from in terms of
absolutely,
it all comes
absolutely.
Back down to one thing about love and peace.
Exactly.
You know, we get too worried about the institutions.
Yeah.
You know, at the end of the day, connection and love is the most beautiful. Important. So,
So you just help all the Latinos too. That's why we have the Spanglish Lounge. So don't feel any different, because if your Spanish is not perfect, my English is not that perfect.
My Spanish is not perfect either.
It's not
very good looking, as I say.
But that's why we have the Latinos in Sydney doing this great
it's beautiful.
Show that I know we're doing at the moment. I'm trying to get most of the Latinos united. That's the purpose of this show.
Yeah.
And the Spanglish Lounge, so we can speak Spanglish.
Un poquito de inglés, a little bit of Spanish. If that makes sense.
Yeah.
I'm comfortable with that.
A little bit. That's what we're trying to. That's the purpose of this.
Yeah, yeah.
You know? And thank you so much for assisting to our interview.
My pleasure.
One of your beautiful talent that you have. These beautiful books that I really want to get them because I have my little one. I want it. Like I say, I don't read, but with these books that have photos, pictures in there, I am with it.
Yeah.
It's very interesting, and you know, the story behind it is
beautiful. Yeah, yeah. No, that's it.
For
that's
it. Beautiful song.
Yeah.
Really got me.
Gracias.
I felt goosebumps. Hay de la carne de gallina. Como decimos. Pero muy lindo lo que haces. Y muchas gracias por asistir a nuestro show.
Yeah.
Y esperamos verlo pronto en live, ¿no?
Yeah, absolutely.
¿Siempre hacen shows o están en
estamos empezando a hacer, queremos hacer un concierto de Soluna, hopefully next year sometime.
Oh, beautiful.
Awesome. We'll do it, and there's a bit of a mix. As I said, it's really hard to know with Soluna. It's a mix of, we can do meditation, we can do Latin, so, but it really depends on la onda, como se dice, that you want to be.
Soluna tiene su propia website también, ¿o?
No.
Siempre está en el...
Pero tenemos un Soluna YouTube channel.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Tenemos. Pero igual todos esos detalles, we can, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, bueno, as Cristian Ravelo, we can find you on the social media también.
Yeah.
Sí, and Facebook, Instagram.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, no, we can't wait to see you live.
Yeah, we'll do it, definitely.
That's right.
Yeah, so keep updated, gente, okay? Búsquenlo siempre. ¿Dónde pueden adquirir estos libros otra vez? ¿En dónde podemos comprarlos?
Through me, through my website, or igual Amazon. Tanto en Amazon.
There you go. Okay. Yeah. So, muchas gracias, Cristian, por asistir.
Okay. Thank you for coming. Thank you.
Jazz
Hall. Cristian, Cristian. Muchas gracias.
Yeah.
Así que bueno, aquí nos despedimos y nos vemos a la próxima.
Okay.
Chao, chao.
Chao, chao, chao.
Namaste.
Con Noches de Arlequín, diviértete como un niño. ¿Sabías que en Australia ya tienes cómo animar, recrear y divertirte en tus fiestas corporativas o empresariales, matrimonios, baby shower, revelación del sexo, fiestas en bote o catamarán, fiestas infantiles, despedida de solteros, fiestas de disfraces, despedida de año, fiesta de amigos o cualquier evento con Noches de Arlequín de la manera más divertida y profesional con disfraces, super amigos, títeres, arlequines, maestro de ceremonia, el mejor mago, DJ luces, el mejor sonido, mejor música. Con Noches de Arlequín, diviértete como un niño. Síguenos en Instagram, @ Noches de Arlequín.
Cuando ella se lava, ella vacila por toda la casa. Cuando ella camina, se pone a menear, hasta en el trabajo no para de bailar.
Ella goza y no mira para atrás, baila sola o baila con cualquiera. Si el disco acaba ya se queda, si la sacan ella baila afuera.
A soñar, hasta en su pesadilla se pone a guarachar. Cuando está herida y de mal humor, se siente mejor bailando al ritmo del tambor.
Ella goza y no mira para atrás, baila sola o baila con cualquiera. Si el disco acaba ya se queda, si la sacan ella baila afuera. Vampira,
no para,
no tiene ni amiga,
no para,
ayuda necesita,
no para,
nadie se lo quita,
no para,
está muy loquita,
no para,
ella no termina,
nunca
no para. Termina.
Soy también por ser como mi familia. inofensiva que te muestras positiva. Parece ser que te conozco de la niñez. Hoy canto fuerte porque quiero que nuestra amistad siga por siempre siendo tan buena y con respeto y más. Gracias yo te doy por poner el corazón, por tu gran inspiración de componer una canción. Gracias soy también por ser como mi familia, con los míos y tuyos, por tus logros siento orgullo. Creando música que nos hace bien y feliz a la vez.
Bachata de la amistad.
Eso, Marcelino.
La vida te enseña de acuerdo a la edad. Amigos se quedan y otros se van, pero no te quieren ver triunfar. Nada en la vida es casualidad. La vida te enseña de acuerdo a la edad. Amigos se quedan y otros se van, pero esta luz no la pagarán.
Si estamos acá no es casualidad. El trabajo y la constancia con habilidad. La vida te enseña, te quita y te da. Seguimos dando cara en esta fría ciudad donde todos vienen y van. Las cicatrices se cerrarán, pero no se borrarán. Unos vamos a ganar, otros van a fracasar, porque el frío de la noche para todos no es igual. Busco mi lugar, busco mi destino. Tengo la energía de los que se han ido. Firme en el camino, no podrán conmigo. Somos pocos los reales que la hemos vivido. Nada de esto fue casualidad. Cuántas vueltas me tenía que dar para completar. La mano no daban, pero yo quería grabar. Ahora estamos bien y no me van a bajar.
Nada en la vida es casualidad. La vida te enseña de acuerdo a la edad. Amigos se quedan y otros se van, pero no te quieren ver triunfar. Nada en la vida es casualidad. La vida te enseña de acuerdo a la edad. Amigos se quedan y otros se van, pero esta luz no la pagarán.
No quisieron ayudar cuando no tenía nada, nunca fueron en vano la primera rapia. El camino recorrió, en mi tema quedarán. Ahora que estamos bien, me van a felicitar. Seguimos dando cara, estamos siempre en el rap. Unos van a criticar, pero no van a opacar. El destino al final pone todo en su lugar. El camino recorrió, no me lo van a quitar. Aunque sienta que todo va mal, la fe y la esperanza jamás la perderán. Dale tiempo al tiempo que todo pasará.
No era amigo que sea, ya no pido nada más.
Quiero envejecer junto con los míos, disfrutar el tiempo que se ha invertido. Esto no fue suerte, el trabajo fue mío. Le puse corazón y ahora estamos prendidos.
Nada la vida es casualidad, la vida te enseña de acuerdo a la edad. Amigos se quedan y otros se van, pero no te quieren ver triunfar. Nada la vida es casualidad, la vida te enseña de acuerdo a la edad.
Amigos se quedan y otros se van, pero esta luz no la pagarán.
Yo, yo, el sufito. Nada la vida es casualidad, la vida te enseña de acuerdo a la edad. Amigos se quedan y otros se van.
We'll be right back.
noche yo te extraño. En mi vida canta eso que no entiendo, que me embriaga. Lentamente crece y dejo que me invada.
Vengo hacia tu ritmo, llevo yo tu alma.
Cuando mis amores en mis manos muestran el misterio del ser humano, se despierta algo cierto, efímero sentir que me hace tu hermano.
Tengo yo tu ritmo, llevo yo tu alma, dándome que quiere que nunca deje de bailar.
Tengo lo que se viene.
Van a ver,
quien
van
no
a ver.
Vive en mi país no conoce.
Van a ver, van a ver.
Ya va a empezar, ya se siente el repiquetear.
Van a ver, van a ver.
Que en mi barrio vive Cheche, el escobillero. Por eso zambullite y vení.
Van a ver, van a ver.
Que el Uruguay no es un río.
Van a ver, van a ver.
Es un tambor que llama.
Everybody here. Thank you very much.
Se quebra el nexo, custodia, patria.